This is WBSM On Demand.
Tuck it.
It's time for South Coast Now with Chris McCarthy. Streaming live on WBSM.com and the WBSM app. Call 508-996-0500. Text us using app chat on the WBSM app. Now, Chris McCarthy.
Good morning. Good morning. A little wet out there, right? Good day to be a duck. A duck, I said. And we must have needed the rain. So my father used to tell me when I was a little kid, we must have needed the rain. So we got it, right? So kind of an eclectic day today. We will have, I got to actually have a guy from the radio station coming in. Michael Nelson. Michael does something very unique here at the station. I think all of you will be interested in it, hearing about this. Even if it's not applicable to you, I think that you'll find this to be really interesting. Michael, well, I'll let him talk about it. So that'll be, we're going to talk about that in this hour for a little bit. Then at 10 o'clock, we have Sean Oliver, the Ward 3 City Councilor, coming in. Obviously, there's a lot going on tonight in the city council. We're going to have Sean give us a preview of that. I appreciate his flexibility and his schedule and his commitment to public service that he's always available when I call him. You know, Sean works overnights. So I did that schedule. It can be really good, particularly if you have something else to do in the day. But it's also can be pretty demanding, but he seems to do it well. So Sean Oliver will be in at 10 o'clock. At 11 o'clock, we will have my friend and to many of you as a valuable friend, Dan LeBlanc. Dan, of course, was the veterans agent here in New Bedford and worked for the VA for a long time. Dan is a published author. Dan served in the Marine Corps during Vietnam. He left an arm on the battlefield, so to speak. It was amputated when he got home, but the communists left, took his arm. But Dan didn't let it slow him down. So I'm bringing in Dan because, let's face it, he's about the closest thing to a guy who thankfully we're not celebrating on Memorial Day, right? And Dan left a lot of great Americans on the battlefield in Vietnam and dealt with a lot of you when you've come home as a veterans agent. So Dan, I think, is really the best guy we have walking the earth right now. There are many, don't get me wrong, but I think Dan's one of the best locally that we have to come in and talk about Memorial Day. So Dan will be here at 11 o'clock. Now, in this hour, we have Michael Nelson here. Michael works for Townsquare Media, works right on the side of this door, really, other side of this. And Michael, tell the people at home what you do, what you can do for them.
Okay. Well, so first of all, let's just talk a little bit about Townsquare Media as a corporation. What most people in the area don't know is that Fun 107, WBSM, 1420 are actually much bigger than just simply the two stations. And what I mean by that is that they're owned by a company called Townsquare Media. Townsquare Media is actually the third largest radio station owner in the country. We have about 370 stations spread out around approximately 70 different markets around the country. And they're all small to medium-sized cities, about the size of New Bedford. And what that simply means to a small business owner is that we have a lot of resources that we can bring to a small business to really help the business grow, flourish, stand out in the community. And we do that a couple different ways. One is, of course, we own the radio stations. And so we provide a lot of marketing and advertising opportunities, things like radio ads, obviously broadcast ads, digital display ads. We have some targeted, online targeted programs, things like that. And there's a whole team that's here locally that can help with all of those types of things. The other side of the table, though, is the side that I work for, and it's really what I call the online services side. And what we do is we really work with small businesses on not only building a website, but really building out the whole online presence. That can include things like the website, SEO, third-party directory optimization, social media. We can do some, again, some website targeting and things like that. And the idea really is just to make sure that when a consumer goes online looking for a business, looking for a particular service, whether it be a roofing contractor or pizza delivery or a chiropractor or whatever it is that they're looking for, we make sure that the business can be found. Because, you know, every day, hundreds of people, if not thousands of people, are going online looking for pretty much everything, right? No matter what kind of business it is, people are going online, going to Google, going to Bing, going to Yahoo, going to search engines, searching for whatever the product or service is that they need. So that's really what we do.
What's funny, folks, is that, you know, I've known Michael for years. And to be very honest with you, I had very little idea what he did. All right. I didn't even know if there was like a third radio station. He was an on-air present. I didn't know. So, but we have shared interests, shared hobbies. I've had him on to talk about those. But he's a firearms enthusiast as I am. So we were talking about that, talking about, you know, in the kitchen, talking about over coffee, right? One day I said, "Hey, Michael, what do you do here exactly, right? Are you my boss?" You know, I didn't know, right? And he started explaining to me. I said, "I think my audience would like to hear about that. I think my audience, many people out there have small businesses and have problems that I think Michael can solve for you." Continue.
Yeah, so, and that's a good point. And that is, a lot of small businesses, you know, oftentimes they don't really have resources to turn to get an accurate assessment of not only their own situation, their own needs, problems that they may be having or problems that they might not even be aware of that are out there.
Right.
But they also don't really know who to turn to for solutions for that. And oftentimes, small businesses are operating under out-of-date or incorrect information, because let's face it, the world of the internet is constantly changing, changes at the speed of light pretty much every day. And, you know, small business owners are so busy with their own lives, running their businesses, that who really ever has the time or the knowledge and can keep up with the knowledge about, you know, what's out there for them? What's the solution for them? You know, if they're trying to grow their business, or if they're trying to, you know, shape the type of business that's coming in, maybe they have a new service that they want to promote, or they really are thinking about getting into something different for their business. How do they go about promoting that? How do they get that word out to the masses? And oftentimes they make decisions based upon what they know, and it's very understandable, and obviously they're operating within the space that they have, but there's a lot of information out there that oftentimes is not disseminated properly or through the right channels down to the small business owner.
You have an expertise in this that is much like the guy who's fixing cars, the guy who's building concrete, all of that stuff. It's a specialty, and you're an expert at this. How do people get in touch with you?
Well, so they can get in touch with me a couple ways. I mean, call me. You can actually, best, probably the easiest way is just to call me through the station.
Okay.
That's probably the most accessible number. That's probably the easiest way. You can also email me. It's michael.nelson@townsquaremedia.com. Or you can reach out to me through my Facebook page if you like. But probably the easiest way is just to call the station.
So here's the thing I like about Michael, is that he's very easy to talk to. He's not one of these guys who knows a lot and wants to withhold it, right? And he's not, were you ever a school teacher?
No.
Because you have a great way of explaining things to people that is not insulting and is not over their head. But you also recognize people's time is important. You're always moving.
Right. Well, you know, Chris, I think you asked if I was ever a school teacher, and no, I have not been. However, I've been doing this for so long that, you know, probably 99% of my role is to teach, mm-hmm. right? I mean, anybody I've ever met with, it's always about really more kind of teaching them, showing them kind of the ropes, right? Saying, look, you know, let's look at your business through the eyes of a consumer, right? Saying, look, here's a way consumers are looking at your business. Here's some things you have to think about. You have to do this. It should be here. You should be listed in this type of way. You know, because if not, then that's reflecting what the consumers are going to see, and it's going to reflect perhaps negatively on your business, or maybe they won't find your business. So, you know, before we can do anything for customers, we have to educate them. We want to know that they know what we're talking about. You know, it's like a good mechanic oftentimes will say to you, "Hey, Chris, you know, if you have a problem with your car, Chris comes in and says, oh, my car's making a noise." Right? The mechanic does the diagnosis. He's going to say, "Well, Chris, here's what we're finding. You've got this going on, this going on, this going on. So to fix it, we need to do X, Y, Z." Mm-hmm. And it's going to be whatever the cost is.
Right.
But you're going to understand that cost, and you're going to understand what the end result's going to be. The end result is the car's not going to make that noise anymore because the mechanic's doing this, this, or this. You know, just like a roofer. Roofer's going to come out and say, yeah, we can just slap a roof on. But before we do that, we really should think about, you know, do we want to pull the original layer off? You know, what kind of shingles are we going to use?
Sure.
All these kinds of things. Because then the consumer is better educated about the process, better educated about what's going into the job, what are some things to think about. And then when the contractor or the mechanic gives a price, it makes sense to the customer. And it makes sense what the end result's going to be and what the desired turnout's going to be.
Speaking of Michael Nelson, Michael is... works here at Townsquare Media, couple of offices over from the studio, and I thought for a long time maybe he had his own radio station. I didn't know. So when I asked him, he started telling me what he does. I said, I think my audience would really find this fascinating. So basically at the end of the day, your job is to get more customers through the door.
Yeah, I mean, that's certainly an end result. Or desired end result. But it's not really just that, because there are plenty of businesses out there, you know, who they feel like they're already kind of overwhelmed with the work that they have. They're already so busy. Sometimes it's, you know, sometimes they'd love to have more business, but they have a hard time finding people. And so we can help with that. We, you know, a good, strong online presence can help with hiring. Creates a positive image of the business. People want to come work for that business. It looks like the business is growing. But the other thing is that, you know, and I've been doing this a long time. I've been doing this for over 30 years now, is that we found over the years, and this even goes back to the Yellow Pages days, if you can believe it, businesses that can be found, the idea is to make sure businesses can be found when consumers are looking for them.
Yes.
So what that means is that a business can shape the kind of business that they're getting in by being in front of people that are looking for those specific jobs. And what I mean by that is that there are most small businesses that we talk to, let's face it, they say, you know, they are busy. They're very busy. They're running around all over the place. At the same time, they oftentimes are doing jobs that are maybe less than desirable, less than the ideal job for them, either in terms of profit or the type of job or the distance they have to travel to for that job, or maybe just the price they gave on a job because it was a referral type situation or word of mouth or came through some kind of a coupon or something like that. So oftentimes what we can do is help shape not only where the business is coming from in terms of geographic area, but also the type of jobs that are coming in. If somebody wants more of a particular type of job, for example, say it's a contractor and they really want more roofing jobs.
Okay.
We can help them generate more roofing jobs to basically supplant bring better quality work in. So it's not about necessarily being busier just for the sake of being busier, but oftentimes it is about working smarter rather than simply harder. If you can do the same work and be more productive, or you know, be more profitable, make more money for the same work, it's a win-win for everybody. So again, it's not just about making the phone ring for the sake of making it ring. It can also be about making it ring in the right way to help shape the business, help the business be more profitable.
So if I'm a, let's just use contractors, since that seems to be an easy one. If I'm a contractor who's in New Bedford, but I recognize the growth is in the suburbs, and I want to be out more in Freetown or in Mattapoisett, or a place like that. Can you find me those customers?
Absolutely. Absolutely, because they're out there. They're going online, whether the business is there or not. If the business doesn't come up under, you know, roofing contractors in New Bedford or Freetown or Dartmouth or Westport or whatever, those customers are calling somebody else. It doesn't really matter whether they've heard of a particular business. If at the time of need,
yeah,
that business doesn't come up, they're going to call somebody else, because chances are they may have heard of those businesses as well, whether it's through word of mouth or radio ads or TV ads or billboards or even just a truck driving by.
Right.
And that's really the key thing is that if somebody says, I want more work and I want more roofing jobs in Freetown or in Dartmouth or on the Cape or whatever, the jobs are out there. We just have to, you know, we can help people go get them.
Go get them. Michael Nelson works here for Townsquare Media. If you're interested in speaking with him, because, I mean, really, I'm fascinated by what he's taught me about what Townsquare Media can do. You can reach out to him here at the station, give him a call here at the station, or send him an email.
Yeah, michael.nelson@townsquaremedia.com.
And again, folks, as he pointed out, he's Michael Nelson. But he works at Townsquare Media, which is the third largest media company.
Yeah.
Well, radio station owner. And so we got national resources all right out of this little office here in Fairhaven.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Michael, I thank you.
Thank you.
I thank you very much. Folks, 508-996-0500. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll get to the news of the day. But again, I thought that in speaking with Michael over coffee in the cafeteria here that I needed to bring him to you guys because I think many of you are looking for him and don't even realize it. So reach out to Michael if you have a small business or a large business and you need some additional customers coming through the door or better customers, maybe whatever you need, talk to Michael. All right, folks, stick around, we'll be right back. So you know that was more spontaneous than planned. There's no charge for it. And if you reach out to Michael Nelson, there's no charge for him sitting down and talking with you, learning about your business and you asking some questions. There's no charge for that, which is something I asked him off the air. I go, hey, what are people going to pay for this? And he said, there's nothing. So it was a spontaneous type of thing. So if I bring him back again, I'm sure I will, because I like that segment. I'll have all the questions. I will have asked him all the questions off the air that I asked him off the air this time. So yeah, there's no charge. If you reach out to Michael Nelson to inquire about how he can work with your business, there's no charge for that. When they start performing something that you think you need that we can do, then of course they charge you. But so anyway, there's no sticker shock there, right? Had I thought this thing through better, I would have known that, but I didn't. So anyway, Michael Nelson, Townsquare Media. So we're going to have Sean Oliver in the next hour. Sean represents Ward 3. But, you know, just because he represents Ward 3, don't discount that if you don't live in Ward 3. He votes on everything across the city, right? You recognize that. Your tax rate, your budget, your zoning regulations. In fact, he'll be talking tonight about the, let's face it, it is a refugee camp. Now, that Shane Burgo wants to build. You got to thank the Coalition for Social Justice for electing Shane Burgo. This is like a dream come true. They want to build a gulag, right? Shane Burgo is building his first, well, look, he's going to take a bunch of down on their luck people and concentrate them out at the airport. Tents. I assume there'll be some fencing right around it. So he's going to concentrate a lot of people in one little camp. He's going to take people who are down on their luck, or he perceives them to be down in their luck, free-range people, and he's going to concentrate them in an area owned by the public, run by the public, in a camp, right? Tents. I assume there'll be porta-potties, things like that, right? Maybe portable showers. So he'll have concentrated these people that really maybe have nowhere else to go. Well, anyway, he's going to concentrate these people in a camp out at the airport, near the airport. So Shane Burgo is, you know, building a concentration camp. or gulag. He likes words that he can control, but I think he's calling it an approved tent city, maybe? A city inside a city, a gulag, if you will. And remember, it will get cold like Siberia around here, or close to it anyway, if you're living outside. So that'll be discussed tonight in the city council meeting. So, Sean Oliver, who Ward 3, this will be near Ward 3, obviously. And remember, these are free-range people. So I don't know whether these people in this camp, the concentrated camp, are going to be locked in. I don't know if there'll be guards. I don't know if there'll be guard dogs. Are they going to have towers with spotlights? I don't know yet. Because again, these are people, and I'm not sure how he's going to get them there. Are they going to be forced to go there by the police? Is it just going to be it can't be a knock at the door, right? Because they don't have a door. Is it going to be a knock on the pine tree next to their hovel? Is there a railroad spur that goes out to the airport? I'm just trying to, I worked out there for years, but I can't, well, actually, you know what? There is a railroad spur coming off the train tracks behind Building 19. So I guess you could bring them in rail cars, right? Because let's face it, if you build it, they will come. If you build it, they will come. Whatever you subsidize, taxpayers of New Bedford, you get more of. Right? Whatever you subsidize, you get more of. Yesterday I had Rosemary Gill. I thought she was delightful. She is the CEO of the Zeitarian Theater. And you, the taxpayers, are going to subsidize some really great performances and arts, cultural stuff. Really events that make memories for families. In first dates, quite frankly. Out of the Zeitarian Theater. You're subsidizing, so you're going to get more of it, right? Shane Burgo wants to subsidize people without homes. Put them into a tent city out by the airport. And again, look what's happening around the state. You have to remember something. And I know you know this. I don't know if Shane Burgo knows it, but I happen to feel he's trying to score points with the governor by giving her an option. Remember, when these names keep coming up on the right side of issues, but Sean Oliver, Ian Abreu, Leo Choquette, sponsored a motion by the city council to reject the governor's tripling of the auto excise tax, right? In violation of Proposition 2.5. They sent a letter to the governor. It was obviously there was 11 city councilors, so it was whoever wants to sign it can sign it. Everybody on that city council. It was quite a coalition. With the exception of Shane Burgo and Joe Lopes. Joe Lopes, of course, works for the mayor. It's an odd setup, but he does. At the WIB board. Joe Lopes really couldn't be seen as going against the mayor. I think the mayor came out and endorsed these potential new taxes that the governor put forward I think probably out of his enthusiasm for the governor, her Democrat party. That is his ballot line, right? But not to be outdone. So I don't think that Joe Lopes could be seen as in opposition to the governor and the mayor who employs him, right? The governor and the mayor employ Joe Lopes. Ward 5 city councilor. Is it an odd configuration of employment? Yes, it is. Do I understand it? Not quite. But Shane Burgo, leader of the Shane Denistas, and the reason I bring it up, that is because I believe he has very similar values to the Sandinistas down in Nicaragua, the communists. The Native Army of the Soviets inside Nicaragua. I think that Shane Burgo has very much those instincts. Just look at the economy of Nicaragua now. Destroyed. Shane Burgo, leader of the Shane Denistas, and I say that on purpose, he wouldn't sign the letter opposing the new taxes by the governor, even though it's really bad for his constituents in New Bedford. None of you can withstand, I wouldn't imagine, a tripling of the auto excise tax, right? You need a car. I was having a conversation this morning with someone saying, if you don't have a car, we don't have a lot of public transportation in New Bedford, right? You need an automobile. Whether you can afford it or not, you need it. So you've got this camp out there at the airport that's proposed by Shane Burgo. Tonight it will be brought up in the city council. Now, the mayor is already opposed to it. I think Sean Oliver is going to be opposed to it. We heard from Leo yesterday. We'll hear from Sean in the next hour. But this is, think about it, folks. If you build a tent city, there is no way in the world you're going to be excluding the illegal aliens. I'm not saying it's primarily focused on the illegal aliens, but neither was our state law on the right to shelter, right? The advocates for the illegal aliens found a loophole in the law, and they drove a truckload of illegal aliens through the loophole and right into your wallet. So the idea that this is not going to be used by the state to shuffle illegal aliens down here and into your school system and all of that stuff. You'll need translators. How many times a week when I'm listening to the scanner as an afterthought do I hear the New Bedford police calling for a translator? It's all the time. And really, it is a couple of times a week. And that is without a major illegal alien concentration camp here in the city of New Bedford. But Shane Burgo, he's a smart guy. Good morning. Thanks for holding.
Hey, good morning, Chris.
What's happening?
Not too much. A little bit of a thunderstorm just threatened by here a little while ago, I guess.
Yeah, I saw the lightning was pretty cool.
Yeah. But then, Burgo there. So he wants to set up a tent city. I think he should really do some research on it. And, I'm here to offer to facilitate that. If you go down to Chaminade Avenue, or maybe Mount Pleasant Street, you take a right over there by the bank and the pizza shop in the U-Haul. Take a right, go down Narset Street. Yeah. Go down Narset Street, go by the liquor store on the right-hand side. Across the street on the left is a place called General Supply.
Yes.
A little bit backwards is the car wash. Between the General Supply and the car wash, it's kind of like an abandoned parking lot.
Mm-hmm.
If you go into that parking lot, you stop the car, you get out, you walk into the parking lot, you go to the back of the parking lot, which is kind of abutting the railroad tracks, which is right up the street from where he's talking about putting in his tent city, right up the tracks, so to speak. So if you were to walk down those tracks for 10 minutes or so, you'd be right where he's talking about. But if you go to the back of that parking lot, you'll notice that they've torn a hole in the chain link on the chain link fence. And you go through that hole in the chain link fence. Immediately to your left, you'll see a couch, couple of Lazy Boy recliners, etc. That's where a lot of these people, they go over there and they hang out. And I'm willing to pay for a tent and a Coleman lantern, and I'll even drive them there in the back of my pickup truck and drop them off, and he can go park over there with those people and get to know them, get to associate them and understand what it's really like to be a poor tent person. I'll even foot the bill for him to live there for about 2 weeks.
You know, I know exactly what you're talking about. You know why? Because this is before I got sick. It was a number of years ago now. I was on scene there because I was listening to the scanner, and I heard about a call for a dead body. Someone had been stabbed to death over there. And I was there, along with Channel 12, setting up the cameras and looking exactly from that very parking lot you just described. And they set up a tent and a screen so that when they took the body out, you know, the media wouldn't be able to see it. And I'd appreciated that. But there was a homeless person who stabbed another homeless person to death right over there. So I know exactly what you're talking about.
Then he can speak from a background of knowledge.
Thank you, my friend. He's got a pickup truck, too, so, and he'll probably take you home from there. 508-996. If you're on hold, stay there. I got one phone line open, actually. So if you want to give me a call, you can, but we're going to take a quick break. I'm Chris McCarthy. Stick around. We'll be right back. Well, you ought to. You can get your Massachusetts certification for your license to carry at the next training class at Shooting Supply. Shooting Supply is on State Road out in Westport. The next training class at Shooting Supply is June 11th, taught by a retired police officer. Stop by the shop, see Don to sign up, or you can go to shootingsupply.com for more information about that. But if you already have a firearms license, right, you can save 10% off the Rossi lever-action rifles, from the .22 long rifle to the .357 Magnum in the .44 Magnum. They're all on sale. 9mm ammo is just, you get 500 rounds for $139 or 1,000 rounds for $259. 1,400 rounds .22 long rifle is just $99. Again, shootingsupply.com. There's tons of great specials and deals there. Also, stop by the shop. Shooting Supply, it's out on the State Road in Westport. Selling Chris McCarthy sent you. Time for you to get a gun license, let's face it. Good morning, thanks for holding.
Good morning, Chris. I can't believe anybody in the city, especially a city councilor, would be looking at this homeless encampment thing. All it does is breed crime, etc. And also, these folks do have a comfort of living together. There is a comfort there. There are no rules, and that sometimes is the problem of placing folks in housing, is that there are no rules. They don't want drugs. They don't want certain things, but they can do whatever they want. And all I can see is them forming their own little community, asking for more rights. You got to bring us food. You got to bring us, you know, whatever. We need a ride here, a ride there. Like, really, an unofficial city.
Yes.
And they don't offer any value to society. And I'll get blasted for this because right now I can't think of a more diplomatic way to say this. But let's look at the taxpayer who is working their butt off to keep a home, to keep it neat, whether you're renting or whatever, but you're paying taxes.
Yes.
This is not what you expect from government. You expect government to give you police, give you water, give you sewer, but not this kind of thing. It's really disgusting. Shame on city councilors for not speaking up more. That's it.
Thank you for the call. I do appreciate it. And folks, I hope that, I know there's a lot of city councilors listening right now. And look, I have a lot of confidence in many members of that city council. I know that doesn't always jive with how I talk about some of their decisions. But I mean, I hope to God Shane Burgo is an outlier, that he and the Coalition for Social Justice, they tried to elect more counselors. I know they've got, you know, they got Maria Giesta, rhymes with siesta, right? Maria Siesta, asleep at the switch. They got her elected. And I'm sure she'll be with this crazy thing. But maybe I could be wrong. Occasionally, the slave pushes back on the master, right? But Maria, who knows? Who knows? We'll find out, because tonight the city council is going to meet and going to talk about this. Tent City out in Ward 1, kind of by Ward 3. But no matter what, it'll be in New Bedford. A tent city. And if you don't think that the state of Massachusetts, with its ever-burgeoning migrant population, is not going to use this tent city once it's set up, good luck. Good luck. Thanks for holding. You're on the air.
Good morning.
What's happening?
I got a question for you. Past couple of months, all we've heard is about ways to spend money. 20 projects, including the Capitol Theater.
Yes.
The Z doubling of the budget. The mayor with his new position he wants to put in. The bid, taking money from the taxpayers. The auto excise tax that you brought up.
Yes.
And the budget. Now, the question I have for you is, has anyone, the mayor, any city councilor, discussed or talked to you about ways to make revisions to the budget for tax cuts that could give the taxpayers some relief?
That's an interesting question. So I have had informal discussions with it. With certain city councilors about that. Remember, I would say that if not the majority, a crucial, there's at least six people on that city council who are homeowners and therefore pay taxes in the city of New Bedford. So they're in the same boat I suggest you are. So there are people concerned with it. I know that, for instance, a number of the city councilors, with the exception of Joe Lopes and Shane Burgo, signed a letter opposing the governor's desire to increase the auto excise tax. So,
right.
So we have some rhythm there. As for this upcoming budget, the mayor, you know, was here yesterday, and I don't know if you had an opportunity to hear it, but the podcast has it. He makes the case that there's very little in that budget that can be cut without being detrimental to services, because a lot of it is already spoken for, healthcare, pensions, right, things like that. So it's a long way to say.
So when we look at this, yeah, Chris, really there's no innovation or any streamlining to get where they could show some kind of way we could save. It's just spend. And I know everybody wants to help out. Sure, we want the Z to give us shows and different things, some of these other projects. To move them forward and make the city better, yeah, that's great. But the bottom line is to be physically responsible and to deliver a budget that for at least 1 year, they can say to the taxpayers of this city, we're going to hold the line. There's not going to be any new taxes. We're going to make the budget work with the budget and make it work for the city of New Bedford. I just don't see with this council and this mayor this happening.
Thank you for the call, my friend. Look, it's hard for me to argue with that. The mayor is a Democrat and a proud one at that. And he wants to spend money on things he thinks that the city needs. And he's got a team of people around him to help him accomplish his goals. That's very difficult when you're a one of 11, right? To try to make an argument against that has any sort of standing when the biggest guy in the room is committed to spending the money and also can explain why, right? Pensions, healthcare, things like that. That's why I wouldn't buy property in the city of New Bedford. I'm sorry. I mean, I'm glad all of you did. But at the same time, I do have sympathy for you. 508-996-0. If you're on hold, stay there. I do have to take a quick break. Stick around. We'll be right back. Want to congratulate a friend of the show, Anna Burke, she's not really a friend of the show. Her dad is a friend of the show. She probably finds my jokes obnoxious, quite frankly. But anyway, Anna Burke, who attends Old Rochester Regional Vocational Technical High School, has won the Mattapoisett Lions Club Harbor T-shirt Day voting contest with what we call a landslide. Just like her old man, Aaron Burke, she got 58% of the vote. We call that a landslide, Anna. Congratulations. She made a great little design of the lighthouse there, Ned's Point. It was a T-shirt contest, right? Anna Burke. So check it out. It's on the Mattapoisett Lions Club Facebook page. So anyway, folks, in the next hour, we will have Sean Oliver, Ward 3 City Councilor, who not only represents Ward 3, represents all the taxpayers in the city of New Bedford. As goes New Bedford, goes the region, so it's good to have people like that on the city council and who are willing to come in here in the studio and answer your questions, right? My questions as well as your questions. So he's not in hiding. Some of them are, though. So anyway, tonight you have a really big meeting at City Hall. We'll find out from Sean if it's going to be on Zoom. I don't know. I doubt it. But those are just Maria Giesta's committee meetings and finance committee meetings and government by shut-in. But anyway, stick around for the local news. It's great local news. Not necessarily news you want to hear, but news you need to hear. And it's done here locally, right? Right here in the hallowed halls of Fairhaven. The Townsquare Media offices here in Fairhaven. Next to the 99. And a liquor store.